Hi guys. Sorry, I've just eaten and drank, so I've got a bit of a build up of crap on my chest. I don't know why. It happens every time I eat. Anyway, I had an extremely busy day yesterday in this flat, and I will show you what I've been up to. And I've also got a bunch of computer stuff for us to look at. There's actually a bag of bits behind me here, and I haven't got a clue what's in it myself. I haven't looked yet. But anyway, we'll just go up this end first. As you can see, TV's gone. Stereo and that cabinet has moved. The PlayStation 2 games have all gone. And whatnot. And I've put this shelf in here with all my pony stuff on it so far. Had to take that shelf down, which isn't a bad thing, because I'm going to move it anyway. I'm going to put the shelf up there, because I'm going to build a custom desk in that corner. So, in the very near future, like within the next sort of couple of weeks or so, I hope, both those computer desks are going to be removed, and eventually that cabinet, but not quite yet. I'm also going to put shelves along here, underneath both of these shelves. So I'm going to use those bookcases to make the desk with, because I like to recycle, so that'll save cash on, you know, going to buy the boards to build the desk with when I've got plenty of board here I can use, because what I'd buy would be the exact same bloody stuff, so might as well use what I've already got. It's only that sort of flat pack chipboard stuff, whatever they call it. Anyway, I just decided to do this yesterday because one of the drawbacks with having autism is having a meltdown. And it can last hours. And it can be a severe one, or it can be a minor one. I had one literally triggered just from an argument I got into online with some stupid woman. Anyway, it kept my mind busy. My printer's now absolutely, well, I sort of took it out and smashed it in temper. Because I just bought a new ink cartridge for it, a new black one, and no matter what I did, it just wouldn't take the paper, and if it did, it chewed it and jammed it. So, and I really had to get a label printed, so I just, well, I suppose due to the meltdown yesterday, excuse me, I am a bit windy, so I will warn you about that. I just sort of lost my temper with it, I think. I was going to buy a new printer anyway, because it was pissing me off. I'm sick to death of getting these, giving these used second-hand ones, and none of them work properly, so I'm just going to go out and spend 40, 50 quid on a new one. Because I don't even think I really need the scanner feature, but I will get an all-in-one, because I have used it. But anyway, I'm sitting on this chair. I'm going to keep it and use it. So I've put my TV here on the TV stand, as you can see. Some of the PS2 games there. PS3 over the other side. Right down there behind the laptop are the demo discs for the PS1. I've moved the other consoles and TV to that table as well. And I've put the PS1 games up there, the Mega Drive and Master System games, and the rest of the PS2 games up there as well. The only reason I haven't got all PS2 games up there, well, I think you can see why. There just isn't enough room. So, I didn't have much choice. But I've put my sort of favourite ones down here anyway. So, that will eventually be built into my computer corner. And I'll have a selection of desktops all set up there. And I'll make a proper little cubby hole to store my laptops in. Because as soon as I've found something, something to do with all that crap in them drawers. I'll get rid of those drawers and I'll put shelves in there, which is why I've got those boards. There's the shelf I want to keep. And that's that light fitting I used at Christmas, which I'm going to dismantle. Keep the lamp holders and brackets and just get rid of the rest. I don't need the rest. My lamps, if you're wondering where they went, some are all up there. Those shelves are now full. That one's full, and that one's all full. So yeah, I had a really busy day yesterday. Right. I'm going to pop you back on here. I might just have to go and take a loo break. I had to tilt you because I couldn't see the thread for the screw. So what I've got a computer. Well, actually I was given two computers, one monitor, and a bag of bits, which is when the camera bloody tilts down. Come on. There we go. That bag of bits that I have no idea what's in that bag. I've only got one computer up here because I took the other one to bits because the case was crap. And I had my scrap being collected today, so I just took it to bits downstairs, bought all the hard drive and everything up here, which I'll show you in a bit. And just scrapped the case because the case was damaged anyway, so I just kept the good case out of the two. Anyway, like I said, I need a potty break, so I'll be back in a minute. Back. I'm back. I would say that feels better, but in a sense it doesn't. But on that note, I've got a doctor's appointment to get it sorted, so fingers crossed I can get it sorted. This, let's turn it that way, you know, is an E-Machines.
There'll be four bits.
Shut up. I'm just trying to see what it's got written on the front here. Microsoft E-Machines. E-Machines recommends Windows Microsoft XP 3240. XP Professional, blah blah blah. Intel Graphics Media Acceleration 900. 80GB hard drive. It's got Pentium 4 processor, 1.6 GHz. 7 USB ports, media reader, yeah, built-in media reader. DVD plus minus RW, in other words, DVD rewriter. Really? 256 megabytes DDR for optimized performance. Right. Before I get into that though, the other machine came with, I have no idea if these work or if any of the stuff I've been given works, but we'll find out probably in another video. We've got an 80GB SATA hard drive here. We've got an ATX 500, 500 watt power supply, and an A-bit motherboard, an A-bit IP35E. If anyone wants to Google it, it's a bit dusty. It's not too bad, actually. This was in a case that looked like it had just been hashed together anyway. It's got 4GB of memory on it. They're 4 1GB sticks. It doesn't say if they're DDR, DDR2. It says 5300, and looking at the style of them, I'm going to say DDR2. So, I've actually just realised, very weirdly, and I'm not sure why, there's no onboard graphics connector. There's an optical connector. There's no serial port. No, there's none of that there. There's just the optical one. but it does have the PS2 connectors for mouse and keyboard. Is this a server motherboard, possibly? For like a home server, for it not to have, I don't know. Weird that it just hasn't got the onboard video. Anyway, I'm going to move this just down here. Oh, that came with that one as well, an audio card. A trust one. Do I trust it works? Bad joke, I know. Probably not now, I've just thrown it on the floor, but... Now, why is it these 500 watt power supplies are so light? And yet, I'll go to my cupboard and I'll get like a 350 watt power supply, and it's so bloody heavy. But anyway, should we have a look in this one? Then we'll get to the bag of goodies. I've got this up here, so we might as well have a look inside. Oh yeah, this is the monitor I got. Smaller than the than this bloody computer itself. Again, no idea if it works. No idea why anyone would want a monitor that small. Maybe I'm just used to using, you know, a widescreen monitor. Well, you haven't said that. That is quite wide, but anyway. It's actually got a dial-up modem fitted. I'm going to zoom you in a little. No, I'm not. There we go. Just zoom you in. Rearrange you a bit. I can't see what the power supply is because the sticker's on the other side. No, it isn't. It's underneath. It's under here. But this one's got an SATA drive. That cable has broken. I'm going to take that off. Got four onboard SATA connectors, Firewire at the front here, as well as two USB and mic and headphone jacks. Oh, I've just found another broken USB at the top here on the card reader. So, because of that, I'm not going to turn it on because then the contacts in the broken one could be shorting out. So I've just unplugged the card reader just in case. Because, like I said, yeah, it is actually shorting out on the side there. Wow, it comes with 256 megabytes of RAM according to this, but there is four RAM slots. So, what are we loaded with? Probably not the 256. It's probably been upgraded. That's 256. Any bets on whether this one's the same? Oh, it's a 512 megabyte, that one, so they upgraded that. I'll just leave that there for the bit. Two channels as well, because two of the dim slots are marked with white clips and two are marked with black. It's got a rear case fan. There's no sticker on it, so I don't know who makes it. Well, there's no sticker on this side anyway. An SATA hard drive here in the bay, and there's room to put another one. Actually, to be honest, I think this media reader is, well, to put it bluntly, fucked. Because there's another one, the one on the other side. See if I can just zoom you in on that. I've got to find it now. You can see the damaged USB port there. I don't know if you can actually see into this card slot, but there is a bent pin in the back of that as well. Yeah, it don't matter, because I've never used one of these slots anyway. And it's disconnected now, so So, the next video I do will be to plug this in and power it up and see if it does anything. Well, it won't with a new one of them.
There'll be 4 bits.
The end is broken. I don't know what, I was going to go like that and point it at the screen. Oh yes, and I got a surprise from Mum today when she came uptown. She's got a new car. They've still got the old Toyota RAV4, but they've gone and got a brand spanking new 2017. So it's literally only just been registered. In fact, when they picked it up, it only had 8 miles on it. Let me guess, I'm putting that bugger in around the wrong way, aren't I? How did they get it? A disability scheme over here called Motability. I did have the bloody thing round the right way, so why wouldn't that go in? Yeah. So, I did have to... It wasn't free, they did have to put some money down as a deposit, but they don't have to worry about repairs to the vehicle. Motability covers that, so if it breaks down it will get recovered, blah blah blah, it's all covered, which it shouldn't do in theory because it is a brand new car, you know. Insurance is also done through them, so that's another headache Mum doesn't have to worry about. It's all covered. Because, yeah, as I've said, ever since my stepdad had that accident on his motorbike, even though, yes, it was his fault, but nonetheless, it happened, and... he's been registered disabled ever since. Right. So what have I got in this bag of goodies? I haven't even got a clue. got another card reader. Cool. I know we don't use these a lot nowadays because everything just plugs into a USB port, but if I'm building a computer up, I like to put one of these on because it just doesn't feel complete if I don't, if that makes any sense. I can see I've got quite a few of these. And a screw in there. That is just a DVD-ROM compact disc, it's not a burner. There's quite a few drawers like that laying in the top here. What's this one? It's just got DVD-ROM written on it. I don't even think I'd give you 2 bits for those. I'm not going to put the bag up on here because it'll take up too much room. Ah! That's a DVD rewriter and CD rewriter, so that's a definite one to keep hold of. What's this one? Oh. It actually doesn't say on the front. Oh, it's just a CD-ROM drive. Wow. And that one I'm thinking is broken because that tray isn't shut properly at the top there. What I will do is set up a power supply. Just a computer power supply. You know, and I'll bridge the green wire with a thingy wire. I'll do that in the video I do testing all this. Show you how to do it, how you get an ATX power supply to work without going through a motherboard. Aha! Keyboards! Oh. That one ain't no good. I'll show you why this one ain't no good. Oh, I didn't know Polaroid. I thought Polaroid only did cameras. Oh dear. I don't even think I need any keys. Right, well, that one will go straight in the bin then. That one isn't no good. What about this one? Something tells me this is the keyboard to go with that E-Machines, because it's got E-Machines written on this. There we go. It's not actually a... what a bad looking keyboard, to be honest. I've got an E-Machines computer in the kitchen, that sort of beige colour tower. Coloured tower. Oh, hello. I've got all sorts of crap in there. Ooh. Guitar Hero guitar. I've actually got the games. But... oh, it is for the PlayStation 2, look. Whee! Yeah, I've got PS2 games for Guitar Hero, so... that's good. Are we lighter? We are lighter, that's right then. I'll bring this up here. Let's get a bit of light on as well, shall we? Right. That actually looks like something my brother might know what that is. That does look like it's an audio type cable. Dunno. Possibly. I might actually, next time I'm over at Mum's, I might take that with me. Unless any of you lovely folks out there know what it is. I've actually got all sorts, it's not just computer stuff in here. These are handy. In fact, this might come in very handy when I rebuild all my desk area over there. You know, stick an ordinary LED bulb in there. I'm sweating like a pig. I don't really want to open the window because it's going to knock some of my ponies over because of the wind. But I think I'm going to have to. Yeah, that reminds me, I've got my trailer to go and put back up the corner later. I don't think there's any point locking the trailer now because it can't really be taken any... fluff? It's lit! I have not even looked at this myself. This is my first time looking in here. What have we got here? Fujitsu Siemens. Compact disc rewriter. There we go, what? Oh my god. No idea what that was. Got an old bloody Galaxy Invader toy. Ooh. Need some work on the contacts. That I'm gonna have to get that fixed. Don't think it's got the from the look of it, it hasn't got the battery case, battery cover for it. What have we got here? Ah, USB mouse, but the insulation is broken on the end there, but the wires seem intact, so mind you, I could always get another USB cable and stick on it. If I really wanted to salvage it, what's this? On, off. What is it? It's made by Status. Max 2900, what, any idea what that might be? Status does light, so I don't know if it's like a thing to turn a lamp on or off. Oh, not more of these. A four-way USB hub. More fluff. Fluffy fluff fluff. And a shed load of assorted cables.
There'll be four bits.
I think Apple Bloom would charge 4 bits for everything. Headphones here, then look. In the car. Answers on the postcard? I have no frickin' idea. USB cable. Oh, ooh, hello. You untangle this, because this has got an interesting end on it. Oh, hang on. Look at that, I've never seen a USB cable like this before. It's got your standard USB cable, but on that end, it's got micro and that. Ooh, that's an interesting. I'll definitely keep that cable. That in my cable drawer. What was this? Oh, it's a USB Wi-Fi adapter. Never seen one like that before. Let's see if that works. And we've got lots of other random cables in here. Loving the repair bin. Bin. This is related to audio, I know that. Let's have a look. May actually, yeah, I think I will take these this cable over to my brother. He might have a use for it. Fuck knows what that is. Yeah, it's definitely some sort of audio cable. Audio video cable, maybe. Keep hold of that one. Oh, what? These headphones are fucked anyway. Well, they're a headset. I want a USB headset. If these are USB as well, I'm gonna cry. I don't think so, though. No. Just two 3.5mm jacks. Game On brand. Right, well, they're broken anyway. Ah! iPhone cable. Keep that, because my brother actually has an iPhone. Silly boy. With iPhones, they're not something I would personally go buy. I really don't like them. You know, I think they are. Personally, I just think they are overpriced for what they are. And they're only over... Dinner's ready. They're only overpriced because it's got the Apple name on. But, anyway, you know, people can buy what they like and use what they like. If they're happy with it, then good for them. I don't like smartphones anyway. 5-volt adapter with a very short lead. I can't. No. Got an Xbox cable here, I think. I look like an Xbox plug anyway. What's it got written on it? Xbox 360. keep that, as my brother's got one. He's got my old one. Bit of electric cable, no good to me. We can go down there. That's the keep pile, by the way, over here. I thought this was going to be an absolute pig to unravel this, but some RC stuff here. Look at this. You plug several different devices in there and you'd be able to use your radio control to control them, so you could have extra lights if you're like making a remote controlled, I don't know, police car or something. You plug your light bar in there and control it from your controller. Might be worth eBaying that. This looks like a homemade adapter for something, looking at this. What's the voltage? 7.5 volt. I'll keep hold of that. There has been occasions where I've needed 7.5 volts. I've got more RJ45 cables in here that I don't really bloody need. What have we got? Earphones. If these earphones actually work, well, that's probably not very hygienic, but I don't give a rat's ass. If they work, oh yeah, ooh, I found some more. Ooh. Look at that. Looks a bit like a Bluetooth device, but it's got two of these on. Keep. Another iPhone charger, some more. I'm guessing that might go with that box. What's left of it? Ew, and someone left the batteries in to leak. I do hate it when people do that. What the fuck are you supposed to charge with that? Although I do have lots of devices with that type connector on, so I'm going to keep that. Because I don't have many of those cables. Plenty of devices. Right, that is another iPhone cable, but I don't think that's the one that will fit my brother's. Found a light bulb. I will keep hold of that. It's another USB with that type of connector on. I'll keep hold of that. I'm not too fussed about the Ethernet cables. Like I said, I've got plenty. More earphones. I don't like using these because they hurt my ears, but they're the best things I've got to use on my MP3 player when I use it. Rubbish. I found a bunch of coloured LEDs. Hang on, I've got to show you these. If I get them untangled from the purple string, that is. And the black Ethernet cable. Ah, here we go, here we go. Look at this, someone's made up. I've got blue one on there, green one, and a couple of red ones. Stick some juice through that and see if I can get that to go. I think someone made something here, because I've got a switch and I've got a little LiPo battery there with sticky tack on it. I've also got that little motor with sticky tack on it going to what looks like, I have no friggin' idea, actually a little circuit board of some sort. Ah, did they make something, or did they take something apart or try to fix something maybe? Broken light bulb. Oregon headphones, earbuds, earphones, whatever you want to call them. Oh. Okay. Another pair is broken. Don't need that. That was cut off of whatever it went to. USB cable. Fucking bit of string, piss off. When any there, basically I've just got a few adapters here, a couple of RJ45s and some phone cable and what about a serial cable? One of these adapters. I think I've got another one of them somewhere. That is it. What adapters have I got? I've got one 9 volt, one 11.5 volt, that's a weird voltage. It's usually 11 or 12. Oh, and another 9 volt. What's this? Oh, it's not a serial cable, it's a VGA cable. Which I will need later for testing that monitor and whatnot. So. Yeah, just RJ45 cables in, a few other random cables, nothing of interest. I'm guessing it was an RC plane or helicopter, looking at that. I may actually swap this RJ45 for the one that goes down to my XP computer, because the one that goes to the XP computer, the little tabs that hold them in has broken. As they always bloody do, just like on the end of this one and the end of that one. So keep falling out, it's really annoying. Little audio connector cable there. What if I just chuck that lot down there? Straight in the rubbish pile, I've just put that lot. I don't want that lot in the rubbish pile. I think I'll call it quits for this, for the blah, 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 blah. I'll try again. I think I'll call it quits for this video. Godspeed Computer Corp. USB 2. 11-in-1 card reader. Yeah. I'll end that video here. So, we've had a look through our goodie bag. Got one computer, one mouse, one keyboard, and whatnot. Oh, a bit too dark. So, thanks for watching. And as always, if you like this video, thumbs up. If you'd like to subscribe, feel free to hit the subscribe button. And, I'll talk to you all in the next video, when we'll be testing what I've got. Testing the computer parts mostly, but I'll show you how to test these drives as well, or at least power them up. Anyway, talk to you in the next video. Bye.